What's up, party people? Carolina Mike here, your host for SharePoint in 60 seconds, where you can get the information you need in the first 60 seconds. And if you're a real glutton for punishment, stick around for the step-by-step walkthrough. Today, we're going to talk about why you should never group your all documents views. And for that matter, don't filter them either. Stick around. Before we get started, thank you for watching. Thank you for liking, subscribing, hitting the notification bell. Can't do this without you. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get the timer rolling in. Okay, first, I'm just going to explain why you don't want to do it, and then we'll do step by step on how to not do it and how to alleviate some of the things that happen if you follow these instructions. First, all documents should be all documents. That's all documents, not some of the documents. So don't filter that view. Also, don't group that view. Let's say you want to see all documents and you want to sort them in like oldest to newest or newest to oldest. The only way you're going to get the true effect of that is by not having it grouped by some piece of metadata, like show me, you know, group by small, medium, large. So, and if you want to alleviate the inability to be able to edit in grid view, that's another thing that limits your all documents view. If you want to be able to edit in the grid, you're going to have to make sure that is flat and not grouped. I don't know if I made it in 60 seconds, but now we're going to show you some of the hows and whys behind all of that ranting. All right, let's rock it out. So first thing, let's take a look. We got all documents here, and that's just what, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but that's what I expect when I go to all documents. That's exactly what I want. I want line by line, every single file, or if it's a list, all items. I want them individual. I don't want them grouped. Because let's say, for example, maybe I want to see the order in which things got modified, truly. So I know that, you know, these two files, even though they are in two different categories as far as size go, I know that this one was the most recently modified. And this one here follows that. Now check it out. If I go into a grouped view, grouped by size, it's going to order them here in, you know, if I sort by, you know, newer to older here, let's see. Okay, we got what, 8 minutes ago and then 7 minutes ago. So, you know, it's showing the order in which they're modified within their relative groupings, which is maybe not what you're looking to do. Bruh. So that's one reason not to group your all items view. Another reason is if someone is trying to make edits and they want to edit, you know, mass edits, quick edits, grid view, whatever you want to call it, that's not available with a grouped view. Bruh. So I'm grouped here. There, you know, I have to go onesie twosies. I can't use my grid. So if I go back to all documents, I'll see that I have the edit in grid and I can do my thing. Well, you might be wondering, well, what if I want to be able to have the best of both worlds? Well, you can't. Bruh. But here's something you can do to work around that. All right, so we're gonna exit the grid view here, and I'm gonna show you, you know, if it works for you, great. If it doesn't, I understand. But here is a workaround if you want to try it out. So let's say I need to make some changes to the medium group, right? And I want to be able to use quick edit. Maybe I'm not changing this column. Maybe I'm changing something over here in another column, the person or whatnot. Well, in that case, I could go ahead and I can just filter on those ones that I want to make quick edits to. So we'll filter by medium or whatever you want to filter by and apply. So now you got that view. Now, quick pro tip, if you want to be able to come back to this, you can save this so that you and only you, and it won't affect anybody else, can come back here. All you got to do is go save view as, and we're going to call it medium because that's exactly what it is. You can make it public if you've got those rights, but maybe you don't want to mess up things for other people. Just make it private, save it. Now you can come back and you got medium. You would do this for each group, and then you go in. Now you got all the groups. You select them all. You can go to grid. I mean, if you need to make, you know, mass changes, or you can just go onesie twosie, whatever you want to do, you can do it. There you go. why I suggest you don't monkey around with your all items views or all documents views, because you want to see every single one of them, so don't filter. That's just clown shoes. And then don't group it, because if you're trying to like sort by a column, it's going to sort within the grouping, not as it lies in the entirety of that list. All right, hopefully this has been helpful. Again, please like, subscribe, all that happy stuff. We appreciate you. Remember, SharePoint rocks, and so do you. We'll see you next time.